So now that's gonna be grand finals. Huge shout out to Jamie Miller. Thank you for coming. Thank you for supporting us. Coming here, making all the way here to get third, really nice run to winners, but...
And it's such a heartbreaker too, because in a winner's final, it was looking so close. He was that close, one hit away actually. He died because he just misplaced his up smash from making top two. But when he had to play a character that he probably doesn't know very well, when he had to play Elixir in all his tricks, all his peculiar game plan, he just crumbled and lost 3-0. Still, amazing performance, showing up to France what Luigi is all about. We don't have a Luigi of that caliber here, and that's too bad. And so, what is this? Some kind of shout-out?
Yep. Grail, of course.
So, Phogos is actually Grail, another Smash 4 player who is here at this tournament, cousin. And on the other hand, yeah, Alex Yao, with a shout-out to Lucid. Les vrais bails à l'ancienne.
So,
well,
the one funny thing is, so they played.
Oh yeah, definitely.
So many times, but during that tournament, they played. Phogos sent Alexio into losers in a quick 3-0.
Very painful 3-0 too. When you look at Alexio's run through the brackets, it was very decisive and dominant, but against Phogos, he just dropped it entirely, much like what happened with Jamie Miller against Alexio right now. So we'll see if this was some kind of triangle where Phogos still emerges winner since he beat both of them at this tournament. Still, so Phogos seeded first at this tournament, definitely the best French player, as he once more shows it by eliminating all of his competition except from the currently ranked 3 on our power ranking, Elix Diao.
This is insane. I'm pretty sure Jimmy was a bit also, just to go back a little bit on that match we just saw, he was maybe a bit nervous, or maybe, I don't know, yeah, maybe nervous because he just lost to Phogos to a such close set, you know? Maybe he played a bit on his mind, maybe.
Perhaps, but at the same time, he really went for creative options and didn't play too scared. I think he just
ranked on that one.
But I do see your point. When you've just lost in a very tense set and you have to play right after that, it does takes a toll on your mental. But that's what makes a top player, you know, even getting back up when you fall. So we'll see right now if Alex Yao is able to do just that, to make a better change after he lost 0-3 to Phogos earlier in the tournament. So, by the way, I see in the chat that we have a huge amount of English-speaking viewers, but actually that's basically all I see. So thank you for tuning in and for watching Jamie's performance. Thank you for watching these grand finals and witnessing some of French best gameplay. Here we go for these grand finals, set one, first match on Battlefield, Greninja versus Diddy Kong, Alex Yao versus Phogos.
Starting pretty hard, nice by Alex Yao, just making some neutral air. Oh, working on the just throwing the banana of the grab. Nice roll. Wait a bit on the center of the stage. Nice take, avoiding the dare could be a lot. Battlefield neutral on a neutral start. I'm quite astonished.
Well, I'm
from those two, I'm really astonished.
Yeah, not Smashville, and I'm a bit surprised from this choice by Alex Yao too, since it's definitely not one of Greninja's best stages. Whereas on the other hand, Diddy gets a lot of reset even with the platforms. It doesn't really hinder his game plan.
The point is, Alex Yao playing really well with those platforms, moving really fast and really safe, I think. So maybe he's confident on his platform game play style, I'm not sure. We're gonna see. So
I think, yep, what happened earlier was I know. Some tidbits, some side tidbits.
Too bad.
Yeah, the side B. Yeah. Got punished for it. They played these two played off stream, and I know that. Whoa! No, only one up air. The second up air definitely would have sealed it. These two played upstream, and I know Greninja and Pac-Man were both used by Elixir, but he still lost 0-3. But the sad part is, since they insisted on playing right away because there's some kind of beef, or at least some saltiness from losing in doubles from Fogos, they played right away, and they picked the first Wii U they found. Even though they saved the replay, they didn't pay attention to one crucial detail.
Oh, nice F-Smash!
Yep, the F-Smash at the edge will poke. They didn't pay attention to one specific point, which was they played on a 1.4 Wii U, so Greninja was actually worse than he is right now. It was not on the very last patch of Smash 4.
So
this might actually change things, we'll see.
Nice fair pushing you in the other platform. And you're trapped. Oh, that up tilt! Waiting really nicely by LCL. But Fogos already on the ground, can make some. Up here. Oh, he falls. The final limb is the grab. Taking really nice distance by Fogos. Like, cannot play with his, with Elixir. Oh, and you know, getting a little bit backward, and Elixir just falling down and taking so many hits by Fogos. Up, already more speed than you. Nice grab.
Fogos putting up so much pressure on the poor Greninja. The lessing tag not working out.
Don't stay on chill too. Nice. Just wait a bit. Elixir tried to stay on the ground, firmly throwing so many grabs in the. Wait, what? Nobody!
Right away, no permals, nothing. Just get out of the face. You have way too much percentage on your first stock. You need to stop, well, hitting me in the face.
Nice roll by Fogos, really missed it with that banana, but still making some good spacing, really close that back here, so of course getting part of those jab, even if you make a spot dodge after it. Ah, nice neutral there.
Neutral there, but no follow-up after that. He definitely could have gone for something like a dash grab, but does not have the confidence yet to go for it. And this is a, the spot you cannot allow yourself to fall in when you are behind a person that much. You cannot play too scared. You need to still go for your BNB, even though it might seem risky. If it's guaranteed, just go for it.
Nice down tilt. Oh, natural. A bit late. He can take it. They fish the down tilt, but nice up tilt by Fogos, but won't be enough to get the kill. But still, once again, with the banana, I think, make the knockback less.
Yeah, I think it might have done just that. Not too sure, but it definitely looked like it slowed down.
Oh,
so smart. Using the command grab, aerial grab, to get rid of this annoying shielding Greninja on the platform.
168% still living. Still 177%! Elixir don't want to die!
I'm still alive.
Nice, really nice. Elixir making a lot of that kind of move, you know?
Yeah,
just short of being, like, or a little bit backward, or just with no moving, you know? What? Making just a quick hit on his placement, just to get hit if Fogos just get the approach. Unfortunately, too far from the edge to get that kill, that back throw, but it was really close.
This is so scary. Elixir is playing an amazing footsie game right now, basically doing a combo all the way up from a huge deficit position. Still got a 76% on this stock, and just drops down and does a raw F smash. Why not?
And for there, still shutting the door on him. It's nice for smash, let's say B. He's waiting.
Yep.
Waiting for it.
Super patient play by Elixir. And again, this platform's playing against Greninja.
Too bad. Oh, one up tilt, one up here, one back here. Already on the ground, forwarder! Still! Oh! He followed him with him getting on that platform once again.
So much pressure. Well, it's just like Omika earlier versus Elixir himself, staying in shield for like a half an hour.
Yeah, oh, once again, the same forward smash that side B, really nice by Lex.
Wow, Elixir too slow on the reaction on the spot dodge.
Nice back here by Greninja. Ah, try to do something with that banana and friendly.
Yeah, Z-drop will get beaten up cleanly by Aerial.
Up throw, up there. Oh! Match 1-0 for Fogos.
And this is actually 1.0.0. Up throw to up air kills. This is again a wrong version of the game.
Well, see you.
Are there any summer French tournaments planned yet? Just a quick answer, because that's an important point. There will be a massive tournament in the summer, thanks to Smash and Sud for sharing that information. Probably happening in the north of France.
Good information.
So, match 2. Same character, and here we go. On final destination now.
And here we go, final destination. Small background check. Elixir loves this stage, especially for this music. This is like his power-up theme. So we might see him going super Greninja-ing, whatever.
Nah, reading those air that you put that dance match, kind of. Really nice by Alex. But now focus. Try to... No. Nice.
For now...
Trampling game on that side, side stage. Just completely making some fair of those banana once again, jumping on the shuriken, but does not really care. Too bad.
Greninja is struggling so bad. You cannot afford to throw a projectile at DD when he has a banana in head, except if you do it from super far away.
Oh, la. He used that edge-to-edge cancel it, double jumping back here so fast. Those movements are really good from Phogos. If one thing can really describe his Diddy Kong, I think it's mobility. Oh, that nice pivot grab up here, but won't be enough, unfortunately. But still. Try once again. Too bad the up tilt of Elixir just hit during the tech of Phogos, so unfortunately missed it. Nice up. Wow! I don't know if it was Smash GI or something to get all that up smash, was really close. That was a nice try on that side B, but Phogos waited to aim at the edge for once. Nice! He read that! He read that second one with that side B, really nice, but still... making him fall, still falling with that grab! Really! He gets him with that force, man, landing! Insane by Alex! Wow!
How will he punish it? Well, with absolutely nothing, with just mental pressure, and will die after this mental pressure. Perhaps you could have punished it, and then... down throw, down shield for a, well, meager 12%, but still, that's something. Retreating back all the way to the edge.
Giving some distance.
Getting a jab, just resetting the situation, creating a take chase opportunity. Very nice by Elixir. Gets a neutral air. Fast fall. Oh, Elixir feeling himself, going for extended combos, going into the flashy mode. It seems as the Ryu theme pick is really working for him.
Elixir get real nice.
I will not stop shouting.
Really nice spacing by Elixir, always respecting more and more of the Diddy and following the banana, but it was really nice. Like punishing so well the side B, taking a lot of distance, now once again rolling away. Get some shuriken, maybe a grab somewhere. Nice. Probably waiting, maybe a little bit too long on that shield. Nice forward there. They jump backward. There! Oh, what?
Nice side B! Just saw that coming! He knew there's only one smash attack you have that could kill me at this place and at this percentage, and that's F smash. And you know what? That's a multi-hit move. And I have side B, and I have a trump card, and you're dead.
He kept that side B, he missed it just earlier, but now he gets it. Nice neutral. Wow! Even if you side B my forward smash, sometimes it will hit you, and boom! So Phogos not done yet on that match. Wow. Avoiding a lot of dares at those air dash. Nice double back here, but won't be enough to follow after it.
Okay. Gets tripped by the banana.
Waiting a bit. Taking some distance. He doesn't want to go. He doesn't want to go. Like on the other stage and finally beginning side B.
Yeah, this is probably a reversal neutral B. Yeah. And a missed input.
Oh, nice catching by the banana. You fall! Up throw, up there.
This is bad. Whoa, nice tech. This was a nice downer, but an even nicer tech.
Yeah.
This is a situation where if you get hit by a Greninja's down air, you're in for the world of an F smash! Outspacing DD's pickup of the banana. Nice up throw, wait for the air dodge, get the up air, will not kill just quite yet. Quite just yet, whatever.
Nice air dodge. Oh, that back here after avoiding the four there.
Oh, this is so-
the banana waiting a bit, roll and roll. Oh, Exia wanted a little really well spaced by crawling.
What is it? Very nice by Greninja, very nice by Nanzero, I'm sorry. With his down tilt, empty shot up, two down smash to cover up the air dodge by Fogos.
He wanted it so bad! You can see, he was like crawling, just waiting, he wanted to tip it so hard, just waiting for the good moment to get that base. He already got the read, in fact, it was already in you. After the down tilt, it was ready for that down smash, in you. 1-1.
Well. This was a real, real good showing by Elixir. Even though it was super close, it still shows that he's able to do better than what he did in the winner's bracket where he just got 3-0'd. We might see something very interesting if Elixir manages to keep going this way. And again, the final destination, the Salty run back right away. Fogos is like, wait, you won, but that's just because you had your music, your Ryu theme on the regular final destination. The only one that should be legal. I will beat you.
Oh, nice. You won't throw your banana, dude. Oh, I catch it. Wow, nice. They're playing with a ball. Chaos. Oh, nice edge cancel. Greninja making a really great job. Just making so many shuriken. That was close, but Fogos didn't jump as high as Alex just covered. Nice neutral air. That up tilt. Oh, that way once again. Okay, when you got the air dodge, he knew for the side B, making a nap smash now after the down smash. And it went for the forward smash. He wanted to put all of them in that combo. Nice. The banana just stopped what could happen.
Nice down air, we'll get him a down air to front air, very clean by Elixir. This might be a good opportunity. Yep, goes for a dash up smash. It was a 50-50. He tried to cover a B reversal by Fogos, but just hit a thin air.
Just turning around, nice jab by Elixir. Oh! Moving shield, banana just right after. Nice avoiding by Elixir. Getting on the left to go on the right, avoiding quite everything.
Nice up throw banana, two up throw, two up air. Very patient gameplay by Elixir.
Oh! He read it and finally missed it from quite nothing. Banana is just here.
Oh, I think he tried to go for some technology which allows players with a dive kick to cancel out their move on the banana because it is a constant hitbox on the ground, but he just misspaced it.
Oh, it was fun. The banana was fun being under it, but it's a run for it, making that up throw and get that kill. 150% to 100% of rage, of course he will work.
Very good situation to be in as Elixir, because with a 111%, I'm not sure if he would die to something like down tilt to up smash just quite yet. So this will allow him to instead tack on as much percent as he can on his first stock of this third match. Yep, down tilt up smash will not kill.
As
this time it obviously will. Oh, nice neutral to up smash, big damage.
Oh, he make it fall on the banana, but don't get really punished after the throw, unfortunately. Run for it, he fish for that down tilt, that up tilt now. Who knows, nice up here on that jump.
Nice jab, out of shield to punish the landing by Diddy Kong. Neutral air will get punished, a backstroke will not take it. Fogos actually struggling right now.
Nice jump by Elixir. Like that, it won't fall on the ground, the banana. So it won't lose so many frames. Nice forward throw, but still not enough.
And we can see Elixir. Whoa, what the hell was that? Won't get punished off it. got lucky here because Fogos overcommitted to something else. Wow, the backstroke with awful DI. Alexia was not ready and lost his stock. Still, very good showing on this stock. Nothing to be ashamed of with neutral edge up smash! Nearly taking it just a couple percents off from the death.
Now it's Fogos' turn, making a little bit of percent. He wanted that Dante once again with only nice biker just before landing to really get that Greninja. Nice pacing with that forward, they just tipped it with his feet. Get closer to Greninja, get the grab. Forward air.
Nice neutral air. Neutral air switching from being a the footstool! Okay, you know, Alexio had his jump, did not panic, still made it back. A bit of a scary situation. But you know, it's these little nothings that can change the momentum of the match. Like, you lose the footing, you just miss a breath, you get hit by an F smash after a roll, and all of a sudden the game is out of your hands. Fogos actually playing super calm and focused right now. Still rolls into a back throw, does not die just quite yet.
Next one will be completely enough. Nice pacing with the back here. If you roll the other way, it is forward there. Nice side B once again, that forward smash. Unfortunately, Fogos won't get the kill out of it.
Oh! And so we'll both destroy the banana and did his stock. Still amazing by Fogos on this on the entirety of his second stock because he had a 70% deficit and brought it all the way back. He might be actually in a good situation to take the stock right now if he gets a banana to as fast as the edge.
Rolling a bit, just turning around. Nice, get the throw. Get the up air, won't be enough. Of course, get the kill. Waiting a bit, making him fall on the fourth match. Work this time! One stock match on the third match of the grand final!
And Alexio was playing so well in this match, but all of a sudden it's looking like he's just been dead even all the entire time.
Gonna throw one floor there already on the ground. Nice back here, that Abby, why not? I think he wanted to just explode on the ground and missed it from quite nothing.
Probably a side B from the start.
Nice take. Oh!
Trying to go for some Falcon technology, take chase with down air.
Missed it from quite nothing, unfortunately. Nice up throw, the up there. Second one. Another third one. Trying already to launch some shuriken. Make a good amount of person now on Diddy Kong, but nice up smash. Banana throw.
And Alexio is now completely struggling both to find his footing and just to take in more percent. Right now he has no openings at all. Up air will not kill.
Oh, too bad, Banana just falters in front of Greninja. Once again the grab, waiting a bit for that air dodge after making the up air. Waiting once again, you hit my shield, throw my banana. A lot of spot dodge, you won't. You're gonna counterattack.
The spot dodge mind games are back. Ball, where are you?
Whoa.
I think there's no damage.
Wow!
And the side B will get punished by your charge down smash. Very good recognition by Alexio. We were all like, wait, does he have his damage up? Is this side B the end? Yep, it absolutely was. He had no options anymore.
And that down smash getting so far away from the edge. Trying to catch it. Come on there, my sword. Come on, go for it. Never mind.
Alexio one match away from resetting the brackets and taking Fogos with him down to Grand Finals 2 on the loser's side.
Insane. Once again.
I don't understand what's going on with the stages. Usually I'd be expecting an entire Smashville set, but it's more like Battlefields and only Final Destination, very uncharacteristic of our Parisian players. Okay.
Nice.
Oh, misses the combo, but still gets decent stage control off of it, so not too bad. Greninja, Alexio just running around.
Very nice neutral air and cross up the front loop.
Yeah, Alexio is really giving up a lot of stage control, but at the same time he makes it really hard for Fogos to capitalize on his own banana and stage control abilities. So it really evens out on a stage as big as Final Destination.
Making with that back here. Alexio cannot really come, both in shield. Nice one! I knew you're gonna jump above him.
Okay, poking with his pretty sides.
He went just a bit before that grab.
Smash near the edge, we'll take it! In this kind of situations, I wonder if Greninja can side B on reaction. or if you need a special kind of setup.
Yeah, I was wondering too.
Whoa. The upper fast fall could have led to something, but this is no fox. He doesn't have enough stun on his multi-hit move to get a footstool after it.
String of the banana. Nice. He's building his advantage right now. He got one stock lead, making a lot of percentage on Elix Yao. Even if you don't get that stock, he's still 53%, and more and more and more are coming. Look at that. Whoa! That was an AD!
Planned all along. I need you, dude.
It seems! Oh, nice throw, really nice. He saw the roll and react to it. Oh, you fall? Nice one. Elix Yao could have taken that edge if he was a little bit too late on that grab.
Yep. Definitely, and that's why also Fogos didn't go for a smash, even though it could have closed the stock anywhere else. And the get up option!
Footstool into banana into dust, man. What? So now Fogos 3 stock to 1. It's gonna be really hard for Elix Yao.
Super green, yeah. Basically undoable, except if Elix Yao just turns it up. 100-fold.
Whoa!
Nice one. Using the side B as some kind of Meta Knight down B fashion to vanish and then hit you in the back when you're left wide open. But is it too little too late though?
Oh, nice. In your way, you're gonna roll. Nice there. Still catching you. I mean, in fact, that side B can cover the option select by Elix Yao, by anyone who just fall after the dare. Oh, just in front of him. What are you gonna do? Jump? Nice fair. And second one. Hurry the banana ready, putting him. Yeah, he tried once again. Yeah.
Yep, and this time got punished for it.
Oh. Nice. Wow. He just short hopped and he ran for it. People grabbed and get a punish.
But just one step ahead in this game.
Definitely. It's definitely not looking like the previous one. Oh.
Second up there.
Elix can still make it. Noble double jump. Oh, he was close to get that side B.
Again, side B will die for it this time.
Boom! And he taunted it after it. 2-2 right now. So, the next match will just seal all the fate of March 2016.
Yep.
Will it be the end of the tournament? Or will it be the reset?
This might be... Well, this is probably the one Smash game in France since... I wouldn't go as far as saying forever, but since at least a long time where there's been so much on the line. 128 entrants in this tournament only for Smash 4. And we had other Smash games present too. And right now, as we go into the fifth game of Grand Final Set 1, we have again Greninja Elix Yao versus Diddy Kong Fogos on Final Destination with another power up music of Elix's. This time, Fogos. Oh wow, very cute footsies with the use of the wall to wall jump back on and try to recover stage control off of Fogos' hands.
He's so fast, waiting a bit for that air dash, but he won't get it. But so many percent getting made by Fogos on Elix Yao right now. Unfortunately, wrong way.
Elix Yao missing some inputs and blaming it on the controller.
Unfortunately, there is a little bit. Get the grab.
As we said, in bad situation when you're on stage, and again using this stage definitely shows that he's worth his character on this stage, and that's why probably it shows it as a counter pick and not the regular Final Destination.
Oh, the trade with Wimby. Well, not really a good trade for Elix Yao right now. Oh, the pressure is really nice! Like, up tilt after dare build?
Yep. Fogos is feeling it. Oh! Whoa! Side B! And again! But this time, I think it sailed the up smash. And even though he got hit by a second up smash with more percent, it allowed him to live. Very, very fortunate for Elix Yao, giving a little time to breathe on his first stock to still tack on some more percent. Like right now with this jab. Pushing Fogos off stage.
Nice F tilt.
The Brawl Best skin move is back.
Oh, nice!
Whoa, and the SDI was real.
That was That was so nice. And he covered the roll that throw.
He threw the banana up, it's a dash grab, and that the only option you have is either spot dodge or roll away. If you roll away, whoa, the up smash nearly killed it, killing Giddy off the top. I can barely talk right
now. Whoa, oh, he knew Alexio was gonna run for that grab. He knew he was gonna make for it, but Fogo's like, no, I'm gonna grab you first and back throw you. Thank you. I don't want your rage anymore, so now get out.
Oh, that's it. Leaving him himself wide open.
Nice, really nice dash attack. Catching him on that landing of that short up.
And Xiao being stuck at this edge.
It's gonna be really hard for him more and more. Fogos making more and more advantage. And Xiao cannot really get in.
Fogos with a rare missed input through the banana in the banana in the wrong direction and allowed Alexiao basically to get back all the stage control he needed. And this time Alexiao is the one putting on some pressure while Fogos does not have a banana. He's trying to make him, get back and gain as much stage as he can while there's no banana in play.
Really nice by Alex, taking them this time and throwing it forward. They just wrecked the banana really nice!
Clean down into front air. I'm not sure if this is true. It is at the very least a 50-50 since you put in an awful situation when you get hit by that down chance.
Fogos moving a lot!
Too much!
Oh, that really nice. Could have been a position, but always moving so well with those bananas, all that kind of stuff. They won't stay too much in you to your shield. I'm gonna grab you that side B.
Whoa, what the hell? Use his up B to just mix up his landing, but still got hit by the lasting hitbox on the DD's side B.
What did he try now? Oh, he catch him with that tech, okay.
Oh, dash attack to Frontier. Thank you, Sakurai, for the patch.
Nice. Oh, you're too close to me, but unfortunately too far for that forward smash!
Just misplayed it, that's too bad. Fogos cannot be happy about that because he would have gotten such a huge hit in this potential last tuck of the set.
Nice job by Alex. Once again, that grab and wait, no, the double jump combo, but nice back here. BOOM!
Headshot.
Oh, he got one.
Okay, neutral air is safe and black, especially with the cross up. Well, with the cross up.
He won that down tilt, but the neutral air! Double jump a little bit after it. The grab, back throw.
Will not die of a throw just yet. Fogos picking up the banana. Alex mixing up his recovery in stage, but still has so much trouble making it back on. Neutral air! This could be bad for Fogos with all the rage that Alexio has accumulated. Oh! He sticks to the edge!
Run for it, missed the grab from quite nothing before, they just push him a bit too far. Getting back in the
Oh, the back air will clearly take his stock off. 96% on Fogos and Alexio perhaps on his very last stock between him and Fogos' victory at Smash 2016.
Jumping a lot from Alexio, just trying to jump around.
Fogos moving at moving so much, like putting out bananas, going right at Alexio. Oh! That's too bad! He dropped the banana in the middle of Alexio's combos, where he definitely could have gotten a kill confirm off of that sour spot neutral air.
Oh, nice roll. Avoiding that forward smash could have been really huge. Alexio used it pretty well with the banana, but for the limits, it was the side B, giving to Fogos some 3% on the green ninja.
And Alexio showing his hand a little too soon, ate already 50% on his last stock. The jab will cleanly eat a spot dodge, no side B from Alexio.
Oh, making for once again, making some percent. Always turning around, always finding those grabs once again!
Bad attack chase, net 85% on Alexio. No, this is way too punishable. You cannot dash at flash like that.
My god!
And this is a last stock situation. This is the difference between a reset and a victory.
Alexio trying to make some punish, but they won't go so far, but now get another neutral air, another one.
Again!
That spot dodge.
Why are you dodging, bro? Why are you dodging?
Missed the four there, but still safe on that stage. A little too far from Fogos. Fogos get that banana, throwing it to that perfect shield, getting it back. moving forward on that shuriken. Perfect shield, dash shield, to get as close as he can to throw the banana, making him fall. Unfortunately, won't work. A lot of spot dodge, a lot of war.
So many
what happened?
The player's in so much stress right now. Okay, banana, two up, throw to up air, will not kill, obviously.
Wow. Only 40% difference, not that much.
Yes, this is actually one good combo of Greninja away.
Oh, oh,
the up throw up air will not kill just like that. This is, however, the last opening that Greninja can afford to take.
He found the banana, not a little bit too far. The up tilt now, oh, nice one, but hopefully he won't get it.
Oh, the smash in the roll, but still, good DI by Fogos. We'll make it back. The tramp, the back air,
oh, and oh
the
reset
by Alex Zero. Wow!
He made that reset on the last move, that last tramp.
The crowd erupting and myself too. Wow, this was amazing.
Oh man!
So much hype. The boss players got up. Fogos was so upset, and Alexeo just needed to take a deep breath after such a close match.
March wow. 2016 is not done yet. You like those two players? They're still here now. Oh my god!
This is out of this world. Like, what the hell?
Oh my god.
I hope you're happy, stream. I hope you're watching the very top French level. Because earlier in the brackets, Alexio got cleanly 3-0'd by Fogos. But right now, he's just showing, no, you know what? In the middle of this pressure, I can adapt. I can show you that you're not unbeatable. That your top first, your first seed is something that can fall today in this 128 players tournament. Back here killed at below 100%. Like,
yeah. From nothing, it was like you just get one. You said it, one opportunity. You get that opportunity, you can see he was like fishing for that edge guard. He wanted to go there, let him go back on the stage, and when he just take that edge, he didn't make any tramp of the whole set we just commented earlier. And now he knew this is the only chance that he got to make the reset, and he made it. We're not done yet.
Alexio was so clutch. Like, with the way the matches were progressing, I was like, okay, this final snake shopping is not working out. This is looking kind of rough for Alexio, even his Finnish music pick. Wow.
Insane. So let's go back for that real grand final at the Marth 2016 between Fogos and Alexio. Here we go. No more second chance, Fogos. Now we get to win this. And Alex, you did it once, you can make it twice.
And here we go again on Final Destination. This time with some Mega Man theme. Okay, my voice is officially gone. I will now preserve it for the remainder of the set and die. An attempt of an edge guard, but where this attempt was half baked and didn't bear any fruits.
Nice, oh, nice piece in that floor there. Ah, he folded! I mean, finally, it was a little bit too late.
Putting some pressure with his jab. Reminding me actually of Jay Miller with his own jabs. Putting up some. Oh, very nice. Side B will nearly take the stop.
Really nice, just pacing a lot, making neutral to fodder, won't be enough to get the kill, but still.
What is Alexio doing? He's moving so slowly, like, in kind of a trollish way, but got punished for it.
Oh! And finally, this AB won't be enough to avoid that. Oh, okay, up throw.
Quick up throw, I did not leave him any room to prepare himself. Apart from, well, reading in advance what was going.
Fogos was trying to mash so hard of that grab, but unfortunately won't be enough. And the banana, the force match, wow, nice jab by Alex, still living! Too bad Fogos lost stock first. With no rage, he missed just what he needed. They roll a lot. Don't yell to up smash! Get a stock!
Tried the side beam to avoid Diddy's multi-hit up smash, but did not bear any fruit again and died off of it.
Nice neutral air. Oh, really nice by Alex. New! Even I say B. Well, this was ready to react.
F smash, not safe on block, obviously.
Alex back on the center of the stage. Really nice. He jumped everywhere, just making Fogos so crazy. You can see Fogos just running after Alex Yao. Not even getting in those timing that they get just early of all the streak and they just dash shield and nice shield. Now that's gonna be, it seems to be a way harder than it was just earlier. And right now, Banana to neutralize further.
Very nice confirm. Making good use of Banana. Okay, side B will not get punished. And this is so crucial. Like, even if he does a side B, you can still punish it, but you have only one shot. You need to do either an option that covers both sides or just know where he is.
Oh, neutral air to forward! No! Wow! What?
What the hell?
Was like, I'm not dying! Oh, what the hell? I'm dying, okay.
That's surprising. Some special move when you're close to the blast zone can actually make you die. But I don't think Diddy's side B is one of them. Actually, I think Diddy's side B is one of the moves that help you survive longer if you do it close to the blast zone.
Oh, that dash tech? Nice, really nice by Alexio, just switching a bit of the rhythm of the shuriken, forcing Fogos to just to really stay into his shield, which was really hurt, I gotta say. Not anymore, all a lot of grabbing.
Yeah, just standing grab, like, where are you going, bro? I know where you're coming. Oh, I'm so aware. We'll finally take it at 140.
Nice. Get the throw. Oh, not back here, but fair! Making him fall, not banana, but finally meet the punishment after it. Really nice. Making him fall while he was shooting some shuriken, but once again, don't get any punished after it. Even if you got the reading, even if you react, he's all a little bit too far, all a little bit too slow. Nice A B. Village can tell the banana already ready. What are you gonna do, Excel? Jump now back in center stage. Really nice neutral there. The jab at the landing right after it. Nice poor shield.
Whoa, where are you going, Excel? This is not the time to drop a stock by suiciding.
Whoa.
No conversion on the banana.
Whoa. Up there. Really nice.
And it's so funny that these guys have been playing like 5 games Final Destination already. Like,
not
why?
Oh! Wow!
Clean confirm.
Once again, Elixir often warning. He won his match always, you know, when it's like. Focus is on the lead, is behind. You make quite of a comeback, but still behind, and make good move, good opportunity, and make a good. Really good hit to get the start. Oh, with this up throw just earlier, that dance match on the edge, the back air at the end earlier, here now with that up air, it happens a lot, like a lot. But damn, the last thing I wanted to say in quad. Sorry, just was one question for the rules. So yeah, Fogos got a really nice neutral game. Always playing his best, like banana, get the throw, get that up there, but it only getting some puck without any real opportunity to get a strong and good kill. And sometimes there's some side B from Alexia who just comes out from nowhere and stopping some smash. And it's really hard for Fogos to make those stock end. Compared to Alexia who got really nice setup, neutral to forward there, the up throw, the smash.
And this setup,
not safe.
It's actually funny because even though he got one setup off of a grab in the entire set and it was the suck he just took, it was up throw to a pair, which is far from being guaranteed. Oh! Alexia, what the hell? This is supposed to lock. What happened? I'm so disappointed. Sakurai, what happened? Anyway, so Alexia, very, very showing us that this character has been worked and worked upon in training mode. Well, please wake up after that. Don't just stand without doing anything. Still, Alexia, showing up some good performance.
Nice spacing goes back here and forth there. Oh, whoa. Perfect shield. Banana right after for him is the punishment. Nice. You gonna shield my banana? Let's see my save big.
Okay.
Nice. You want to get in, you throw the banana a little bit too far, so you cannot really hit him infernally. Taking some distance, once again into his shield. Nice, really nice grab.
I'm still upset about that footstool.
Nice up smash.
Why didn't it look? You're so beautiful off of a neutral B.
You're that kind of guy. Oh. Nice wall there.
For the showing up a really strong wall. Blocking Alexiao at the edge, but dropping it.
That was really nice. I love how he make the pressure. He just, you know, throwing banana, letting him in shield, and just pushing him a bit and a bit and a bit and a bit to finally get those side B on the ground.
The kick.
Oh no!
This cannot have been. He did the side B off stage and press B again. So when he does that, DD cannot use his up beam recovery move.
Too bad.
Okay, side B. Focus really in control of this game. This is going towards a 3-2 situation, set 2.
Probably will be a nice subs match. Won't be enough in front of the lane. Oh! Whoop! Too bad.
Okay, I think you're done. No? Okay. Zero rage will not kill yet.
Oh, nice! Really nice! Force again, you know, to just get the rhythm of be neutral to get on the neutral recovery, but already banana was there and that was it.
We just had one of Alexiao's go-to basics, and I don't really know why he likes doing that. Just does up throw to charge down smash, no followers possible, but still gets in the opponent's head. Obviously, oh, I just got hit by charge smash at 0%. I'm so obvious.
Oh, nice, nice. Behind him, so he won't get grabbed. Oh, that was nice. Okay, pushing him away, getting back the banana, making him fall. Alexiao only getting hit from those when he's on the edge from now on.
Yeah, definitely.
Oh, yeah, not this time.
That there will not kill. Very strong showing by Fergus in this game altogether. Yeah, again, Alexiao finding himself at the edge, having to circle around with all the peanuts and bananas flying at him.
Nice side B. You want it so bad, you want it so bad. Finally, missing the reverse grab, spacing that down tilt, turning around. Will he? No, unfortunately, won't get him.
Decent follow up with a sour spot neutral air to do a sour spot up smash.
Oh!
Again, oh wow, this is so powerful.
Once again, 90%!
Yep.
His stock is gone!
And Fergus, when he got hit by that, just threw a quick look behind him to his brother, which supported him from afar, and threw a little good game at, nicely done at Alexiao. So, nice partnership there, recognizing the smartness of the option picked.
Making fold for him to get up, just stops him! Oh, nice grab.
Wow, the read on the wall from so far away.
Nice jab. Oh. That was a try down tilt to dash people back here, yeah. But fall a little bit too far to hit him. So Alexiao running from one side to the other until Fergus gets that grab.
quick back throw, 180%, no shame to die off of that. Whoa.
1-1.
Fogos, yeah, Fogos really brought it back. But again, in the whole duration of this Grand Finals, it's been one game to one player, one game to the other. And each time, we're like, okay, it seems like he's figured out something. The game after that makes a slide. Even though most of the closest games have been the ones going to Alexiao. So overall, Fogos' wins have been more convincing than Alexiao's, but still, on the whole scale, the bigger scale of things, Alexiao did win an entire set right there.
They're sharing the water. Yeah.
Oh, wow, this
is so cute.
Yeah, I mean, like, this is sportsmanship as its finest. They're both drinking from the same bottle of water.
Those guys, from the bone of the water, they'll be together. And oh, we're back, but not the same music. Now it's gonna be B type, not A type. So here we go now, Alexiao, ready for his team song. We gave him the same energy as earlier. We'll see. Now he's running.
Yep.
For sure, he got legs.
And finally, first person after 13 seconds of game.
Whoa. Okay, new. Once again.
Exchanging projectiles.
Nice.
It's fun because in the duration of this set, we've seen both players sometimes exchanging projectiles at this specific range where even with a banana in hand, the GD cannot finish a shuriken thrown by Greninja. But on the other hand, when they're very close back, just like that, it's a cat and mouse game, very close, very fast paced.
Yeah, but banana friendly. Don't throw the banana as early as you would like to, I think. Get it back, making him fall. Really miss this opportunity after the dash. Stop to beat. Turning around, making the banana on the ground. Jumping, nice forward smash. Just pushing him a little bit in that neutral air, avoiding the grab, and then punching him with that forward smash. Really nice by Alexiao.
Very, very reminiscent. Oh wow, the read on the roll was phenomenal. This is starting to look pretty bad for Alexiao. Well, I'm not counting him out just yet because his reads and the hard reads have been, well, the hardest. Like his side B at 90% on the other game. But still, looking a little grim as this game closely resembles the game that just happened, which he lost.
Once again, not too many percent to really follow that up here. He can double jump out of it. Nice play there, they're landing new. He saw the side B making really great spacing. Oh, he drives that down tilt, but Fogos catch him with his own. Once again, he's ready to make that play after the down tilt. You know it when you see Alex starting to crawl like that. But unfortunately, missed it from quite nothing once again. But still catch him at the on the landing.
Oh, finally, my, what was that? God. A down air?
Back here, I think it was the first of the back here, I think.
Oh, an up throw banana to up smash to cover an aerial cross up by Alexiao. Jab, okay, jumps over him, no punish though. Very nice F tilt to punish the attempt of Fogos to shield grab a neutral air from Alexiao.
What the pressure! Back here, the banana bounce on him with another back here. It was fun. Nice.
Okay.
Try to space the bit and follow the wound. Catch him. Nice! Really nice down tilt. Nice spaced, but unfortunately, not for anything. Ah, really
okay,
nice.
Nice.
Oh, enough to get a kill.
Yep.
Whoa.
this is actually a strong projectile. It has some interesting properties too, like we've seen with the footstool earlier, to blow some combos. Oh, nice smash, this is bad. This is the I'm panicking and I must say situation, but still, Fogos finally makes it back.
Close the range, that banana, forcing him to make that down, that dash attack and catching him that side B really nice. Even if he's back on stage right now, he's still making the pressure. Getting closer and closer, but avoiding the grab of the shuriken, but still gets him with an upper on the landing, forcing him to put the shield. Try to follow the roll, and finally missed it. Now Alexio get the grab and starting to some upper strings.
Putting some pressure. Finally, Alexio has the opening that he hasn't found in the entirety of this stock. Will not get punished. Obviously, the side B. Fogos finding a lot of mileage off of side B's for this match. A lot more than what he's used in the first set.
Nice.
Just again, the side B will cover all of Greninja's defensive options. He needs to roll away in this case. Oh!
Forward smash
grab will not kill just yet.
He don't want to risk the forward smash because of the side B, but unfortunately the forward throw wasn't enough. The back throw now, not as close as he wanted from the edge, unfortunately.
The jump! But very good reaction by Alexio, and very good angle.
No, not this time. He unfortunately missed what he wanted to do. Wow, that shield on the troll was so important, but still not dead.
This is getting super scary. Oh, and what's again, wrong? The read.
192%, 97, and still living. Oh, that up throw.
Very slick movement.
You know.
I'm smashed, I was not with end of stage. Jericho wins it!
Fogos to get the get it! Unfortunately, even if he gets this spike, he misses out B and makes the fast fall too fast, and he lost that match from nothing!
Oh wow, this is such a heartbreak. I didn't understand. I saw Fogos getting up and fist bumping, and I'm like, whoa, okay, these guys have shown sportsmanship, but it's a world hold level. You won't fist bump when you lose. And actually, from this tiny bit of time that Alexio could not manage to buy from the game, he just lost the game. So what's it like? It's like 2-1 for Fogos?
Wow.
That was insane. It was so close because of that fast fall. Fogos didn't even take it.
Yeah, he was dead because GD cannot even meteor cancel or anything. If he does his upbeat when he's going down, it actually spikes him even further. So it was basically curtains for GD Kong. Just too bad on Alexio's part to have missed.
Insane.
Wow.
Kind of mad for Alex right now, really. But still, that was so... dude, so many throws, so many person from Alex, and once again, Fogos gets in trouble to kill Alexio, and from nothing, it was to that, to make that comeback, just one little kill, but he missed it from nothing, and here we go once again, 2-1 for Fogos, Alexio won't give up, and here we go on final destination once again.
So again, it was the same situation in set 1 of Grand Finals, where Fogos was up 2-1, and it was a 2 victories back-to-back from Alexio, which allowed him to reset the bracket. We'll see if he manages to do something similar here to win the tournament, or if this will be the last match of MAS 2016. Okay.
Just running away, avoiding the banana with that. I roll behind him, get the grab, fall there, okay. Just want to make some clean percent. Always the shield, just right after miss somehow. Oh, you're full.
Very nice setups by Fogos, punishing again and again the landings by Alexio. Very nice.
I'm waiting for the take.
You can take if you want, but I just have to hold my shield, to hold my smash.
Okay, get the banana, I get to get in. Get the throw, the upper won't be still not enough to get the kill though. Oh!
So, this might be it with a shuriken. Okay.
No!
Oh, nearly saved him, I'm actually surprised. Because as he took damage with the water, I was half wondering if this would give him back his AB. But it didn't, it acted much like a Mario's cape. Which does damage but do not refresh your AB. And right there, finding upthrow up air at right the the percent threshold where it's still a guaranteed combo and it will kill.
Really close, really close. Nice job. Get that dash at I. Reed still making the pressure. Moving a little bit backward to just still trap Fogos on those movements. But Fogos making back, trying finding a hole and reversing a bit of the situation, but not that much. Trying to now, oh, need some space. It's just insane. You don't know who is fleeing, who is pursuing the other. Yeah. It's always switching.
The cat and mouse game, when they're both in their neutral stance, very close to each other, and there's not this whole camping game going on. It's so fast paced. You really need to be focused to detect exactly what's going on in their head and why they're doing these choices.
Ready. In the area, I'm just Elixir just jumping in the way, all the way, just making folks completely crazy, forcing him to make any movement to get a punish, to get some space or anything.
Okay, after a very gain, getting scary for Elixir, but as we've seen for most of the games, he's always been down in percent. But since his character has more kill durability and kill power, it's not too bad. No side B, okay, we'll just play on the fact that Greninja is a fast follower to try to go down and shield, which he does, but no punish after that. The front end is yet. This might be Elixir's last stock of the tournament, and as he contemplates that, he sits on the platform and just collects himself before going in for his, perhaps, final fight.
Trying to get that side B in front of him, missed it from quite nothing, so Fogos makes some 3% that side B. Falling on the banana, too bad after that neutral air once again!
Whoa! But does not connect with the sweet spot of the up smash. Definitely had the right hitbox on the neutral air.
Nice forward throw, throwing some shuriken, making some hit. Will he try something again? At least he's making some pressure just by his positioning. Nice throw by Fogos, making some percent. He need to be the best. That side B,
very clean!
Oh my god, this is not done yet!
This might be the last stock of the tournament for Elixir, but it is also his chance to take it to the last match of the tournament.
So you're taking some space once again. Oh, really nice grab. Four other 82, oh, percent, 92 right now. The shuriken now, trying to make some space. Oh, the... This could be bad for Fogos, but nice catch!
Fogos kind of panicking right there, leaving himself wide open for Elixir's pressure.
Oh, falling down, but still here.
A B, mixing up his recovery. He knew he was in a bad spot between a banana and a Diddy Kong, a rock and a hard place. Nice shuriken! Oh. No jump, will be forced on the edge!
Missed it.
Nice frame trap with the front air.
Oh, really? No, unfortunately, from quite nothing. It was a little bit too far, it will have him. But nice out throw, not a pair. The neutral had the landing, rolling to avoid the down tilt. Trying to go on him just a bit, but spacing pretty well.
And this is it! This is it! Fogos finds the banana throw to dashing up smash. And he takes it 3-1 in his second set of grand finals of Mars 2016. Elixir finally falls to Fogos with a much better showing than what he had in the winner's bracket.